A U.S. nuclear submarine hit an unknown object while submerged in waters in the Asia-Pacific region, injuring a number of sailors, U.S. officials say. It was not clear what caused the incident on Saturday, they said. The submarine remained fully operational. Unnamed officials told U.S. media the collision happened in international waters in the South China Sea, and that 11 sailors had been injured. The incident happened amid rising tensions in the region. The U.S. Navy said the extent of the damage was still being assessed and that the submarine's nuclear propulsion plant and spaces had not been affected. The statement did not give details about where the incident took place or the number of people hurt, saying only that the injuries were not life-threatening. But two officials quoted by the Associated Press said two of the 11 sailors that were hurt had injuries that were classified as moderate. All of them were treated on board the submarine. Those officials said the incident took place while the submarine was conducting routine operations and that the Navy did not make the news public before Thursday in order to maintain operational security. According to Associated Press, the official said the object the USS Connecticut collided with was not another submarine. One of the officials quoted by the agency said it could have been a sunken vessel or container, or other uncharted object. Alexander Neal, a Singapore-based defense and security expert, told the BBC the number of injuries caused by the collision suggested the submarine probably hit something big and was going really fast. The incident, he said, was uncommon but not unheard of and had exposed how busy the area was with military activities. The South China Sea has been increasingly saturated with naval vessels from a number of different countries. While there's been a lot of show of force by surface vessels, you don't see the level of activity under the surface, Mr. Neal said. In comments reported by Chinese state-run Daily Global Times, a spokesman for the Ministry of Foreign Affairs said China was seriously concerned about the incident, calling on the U.S. to provide further details, including the purpose of the mission. The submarine was later reported to be heading towards the U.S. territory of Guam. USNI News, a site specialized in the U.S. Navy, said the last known incident where a submerged U.S. submarine struck another underwater object was in 2005, when the USS San Francisco hit an underwater mountain at full speed near Guam. One sailor died in the incident. The USS Connecticut was operating in one of the most contested regions in the world. China claims most of the South China Sea, but surrounding countries and the U.S. disagree. The Philippines, Brunei, Malaysia, Taiwan, and Vietnam have all been disputing China's claim to almost all of the sea for decades, but tension steadily increased in recent years. The U.S. has backed many of these countries in this territorial dispute.
American leadership must meet this new moment of advancing authoritarianism, including the growing ambitions of China to rival the United States.
The incident comes just weeks after the U.S., U.K., and Australia agreed a historic security pact in the Asia-Pacific, in what's seen as an effort to counter China. Meanwhile, the U.S. National Security Advisor, Jake Sullivan, told the BBC he was deeply concerned about actions that undermine peace across the Taiwan Strait, which separates Taiwan and China. He was speaking after China sent a record number of military jets into Taiwan's air defense zone for the fourth day running. Beijing said other countries' patrols in the South China Sea were provoking incidents and creating contradictions as it rejected a German warship's port call request. In response to the German Foreign Ministry's announcement that the frigate Bayern had been refused permission to visit Shanghai, Chinese Foreign Ministry spokesman Zhao Lijian said on Thursday that countries outside the region should respect regional countries' efforts to maintain peace and stability, and play a constructive role. China attaches great importance to the development of an all-round strategic partnership between China and Germany, including cooperation between the two militaries, and is willing to carry out friendly exchanges on the basis of mutual respect and mutual trust, Zhao said, adding that it was up to Germany to create a good atmosphere for this. Zhao again accused a few powers of frequently conducting freedom of navigation operations in the South China Sea to flex their muscle and instigate trouble. He said China was determined to safeguard its sovereignty and maritime interests. The 4,000-ton frigate Bayern set off from Wilhelmshaven last month for a six-month mission to the Indo-Pacific, including the disputed South China Sea, to strengthen Germany's presence in the region. China has overlapping claims with several neighbors to the resource-rich South China Sea, through which about a third of global trade also passes. China denies requests for German frigate to make port call in Shanghai. The United States has frequently deployed its warships and planes to conduct freedom of navigation operations and naval exercises in the region to challenge China's claims, and asked its allies to do the same. Before the Bayern's departure last month, German Defense Minister Annegret Kramp-Karrenbauer said its goal was to show allies in the region that we are standing up for our values and interests together. She also said she wanted the European Union to establish a permanent presence in the region. After the rejection of the port call request, the frigate's route was updated to include a stop in the northern Australian city of Darwin. Xian Hong, an international relations professor at Renmin University, said that for nearly a year, the German government had been repeating remarks about coordinating with allies, establishing a strategic presence and safeguarding freedom of navigation, and this was probably the cause of Beijing's anger. According to these statements, Germany's motives could be reasonably considered by the Chinese government to be harmful to China's security interests and sovereign claims, he said. Under those circumstances, we could imagine that China would refuse the German warship permission to call at Chinese ports.